So to start off, I'm going to prime my face with this Pixi Poreless Primer, I believe it's called. And I'm just going to dab this all over my face where I want my foundation to go on smoothly. And next, I'm using this Smashbox Pore Minimizer. Like always, I say I love this product. I don't think I'll ever get tired of it. It's just amazing. It hides my pores like nothing else, not even the professional. Right there, I was checking to make sure my face was dry enough so I could go ahead and apply my foundation, which is the Urban Decay Naked Skin Foundation. And I haven't used this foundation in a while, but when I used it today, oh my god, I am literally addicted. After I did this makeup look, I used it for about the next 2-3 days. And I'm trying to like not use the same foundation every time because, you know, I want to test out all my foundations. I want to use them up and, you know, so I could review newer ones. And yeah, so I'm just blending this all over the face. And right here, yes, I'm acting like I'm in a video. I have the fan going on so it could dry my foundation faster. Next, I am going to be going in with the new Urban Decay Naked Skin Concealer. And this product, honestly, to give you guys like a first impression, it was really nice. It blends easily, beautifully. I highlighted all over the parts that you guys are seeing right now. So like I said, it blends easily. It just looks very natural on your skin. Even though I used it as a highlighter, it just went on and like sinked into my skin. I loved it, honestly. I highly recommend this concealer. I did use it for, I think, a couple hours. I think I had this foundation or this makeup look for about 5 to 6 hours, and it did not crease at all. I did set it with the powder, so, you know, you always have to set your concealer with the powder. If not, it will crease for sure. But yeah, definitely will recommend this concealer. It's amazing. It is pricey. It's at $28, I believe. And I mean, you know, like they always say, you get what you pay for, and this one definitely is worth it, I think, to me. I would for sure purchase it again, but it is going to be a concealer that I do use when I go out at night, because I did get it in a shade that it is, my arm was tired right there because I was blending and blending forever. So yeah, like I said, it is going to be a nighttime concealer because it does have a very full coverage look. So now I'm using this Morphe palette, and it's the 06F, I believe. Yeah, I think it is. This is their contour and highlight palette. I recently bought this because Manny MUA, if you guys don't follow him, he's here on YouTube. He recommended this palette. You could check out his channel, and he has a discount code for 10% off, so you guys could just look them up right there on YouTube. Now to set my whole face, I'm using my Maybelline Fit Me powder that I just bought as well, and I'm just setting my whole face with this. And this powder is really nice, but since I have a full coverage look, I haven't tried it with like a BB cream to see if it covers me even more, but with this whole look, it did cover me really nicely. So now I'm gonna prime my eyes. I'm like watching Sex and the City while I'm like talking to you guys. Sorry for that. But I prime my eyes with Painterly Paint Pot from MAC. And now I'm using this new NYX Brow Pomade. And honestly, just to give you guys a quick review, I think this is a great alternative, but it's not as amazing. I did have to dip my brush into the pomade quite a bit of time because my Anastasia, literally, I think my Anastasia Beverly Hills pomade, I usually go in for about 2 dips, but this one, I had to dip in it for, I don't know how many times, like 6-7 times, I believe. But I mean, you do achieve it, but it just takes longer. I mean, I don't know. This is a great alternative. If you're in a budget, I recommend it. It's nice. So just to pretty much shape my eyes, I'm using MAC, what is it? Soft Ochre? So I think it's Soft Ochre. Cream Pot just to define my eyebrows and make them look a little bit nice and cleaner. So next, I'm going to set that paint pot with the white shade, or it's like a cream shade in that contour Morphe palette. And I'm just gonna set it, I guess. I can't talk today. next, I'm going to use the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Gel Mascara. And you guys should check out Ulta's website. They're doing their 21 days, I believe, 21 days of beauty. And they're gonna have the clear gel mascara for I think $11 on the the 20th. I'm not exactly sure, but check out the website. It's normally $21 I think, and it's half off. So I would snatch it if you guys can, because these mascaras, or these clear eyebrow mascaras, are amazing. They hold your eyebrows put. So if you have crazy eyebrows, I would definitely recommend this. So I'm using the Maybelline, Black is Black gel liner. And I just did, you know, the whole shape of the eyeliner that I want. And I'm going bold with this look. So, you know, it's a bold look. and I'm filling it in because this gel is so black. And once it sets, it does not move. So this is the type of gel that I would recommend. It's like $5 at Target, you guys. So affordable. Anybody and their mama could get this brow, or what is it? Not brow gel. I'm still on the damn gel thing. This eyeliner. It's really, really good. So I'm doing the same thing to the other side. This is not a look that goes with anybody. Not everybody could pull this look off, but you could definitely try it out. And you know, if you like it, wear it. If you know, if you don't wear it. But I would always say, try something once. If you don't like it, you know, you don't like it. But you know, at least you tried. So I'm using that paint pot again, the soft ochre, to just clean out that wing liner. I did post this picture, and tons of you guys were saying, "Wow, that!" Oh no, on my YouTube comments, tons of you guys were saying that, "Wow, the eyeliner looks nice and sharp." And the trick to doing that is to use a concealer, or like the paint pot that I'm using, just to sharpen up that wing liner, because that's gonna give you the most perfect wing liner look. So that's a nice trick that tons and tons of makeup artists do, because you know, you don't always get that perfect wing look, so using a concealer like that will do the trick. So I'm just cleaning that up. So next, I am going to set that eyeliner with Makeup Geek's Corrupt Eyeshadow. If you guys have not heard of Makeup Geek, definitely check them out. They are very affordable. They are online. I think they are opening a store in Sacramento. But definitely check them out if you have not heard of them. But this is the blackest eyeshadow you'll ever find. It is so pigmented, like crazy pigmented. So now I'm using this Urban Decay black eyeliner. It's like their blackest eyeliner ever. And I'm just putting this on my waterline, on the top waterline, or underneath my eyelashes. And I'm using the MAC eyelashes. I don't know the name to them, or the number actually, but I will list it down below, of course. But these are very spiky, and they just complement this look very well. So now I'm mixing two Makeup Geek eyeshadows. I want to say it's Frappe and Creme Brulee, but I'm not exactly sure because I don't have them in front of me. But of course, they'll be down below. Now for my bottom lashes, I'm using Rimmel's Lash Accelerator. I just bought this, and actually I've been loving it. The brush is very, very tiny, and it just gets every hair. And I don't have like long thick hairs, so this actually makes them look a little bit lengthy, so I like this mascara. I'm using the LA Splash glitter glue, I believe it's called, and then the Kryolan, I think it's pronounced Kryolan or Kryolan, glitter in gold. And I'm putting this directly mostly in the inner part, but not making sure that I don't make it go into my eye, because If you wear contacts like I do, I wear them to see. It is a pain in the butt because it hurts so much. If one of these glitters goes into your eye, oh my god, it hurts like nothing else. So right now I'm here letting it, right there I'm letting it dry with the fan, because if you have hooded eyes like myself, you will crease easily if you don't let them set. You have to give it about a minute or two to let it set, because it will crease, because you have to let the glue set and you have to let the glitter set as well. So right here I'm bronzing my face. I am going to be contouring as well with the darker shade from that palette, but I'm just putting this all over my face just to bronze up my face, because I don't technically contour all over my face when I contour, so I just want my face to have more of a shape. So here I'm using the Ida brush from NARS, and I know this brush is back in stock, so you guys should definitely check them out. This is an amazing brush, but I do have alternatives to brushes that I use that are high-end. I do love some e.l.f. brushes, of course, Morphe brushes that are very, very affordable. And I am working on filming my favorite go-to brushes, like alternative brushes to my favorite high-ends, like this Ida brush. I know that not everyone can afford it. It is expensive. Myself and my friend did get it cheaper than the price. But we did fight to get it cheaper, but yeah, so I will have that video hopefully in the next couple weeks or the next month. I do have tons of videos that I want to film for you guys. So now for blush, I'm using Milani's Pink Blush in Luminoso. This blush is universal, you guys. If you have not tried it, definitely go check it out. Check Walmart. If there's a Walmart around you, check it out, because it will be cheaper there. And yeah, my husband said something, I don't know why I did that, but yeah. I'm using MAC's Soft and Gentle highlight. I love this baby. I honestly didn't use it for a couple months, and then I just grabbed it one day and fell in love all over again. I'm using my new matte lipstick from LA Splash in Charm. These are so beautiful, you guys. I do have pictures of them on my Instagram, so check that out. So this is all, you guys. I hope you enjoyed this. Please give this video a like if you like this look. It's very easy. It literally just takes time, so it takes patience. But yeah, hope you guys like it. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye. So today I'm going to be doing a giveaway. I am going to be choosing 5 people.